guys, welcome to another That Was Year That Was, and this year we're looking at 1983. Yep, let's have a look. Charts wise in the UK, rundown from 10 with David Bowie with Let's Dance. Number 9 with KC and the Sunshine Band with Give It Up. Number 8 was Men at Work Down Under. Ooh, yeah. Number 7 was Rod Stewart with Baby Jane. Number 6 was The Police with Every Breath You Take. Number 5 was Spandau Ballet with True. Number 4 was Paul Young with Wherever I Lay My Hat, I Can Never Remember. Or That's My Home, whatever it was. Number 3 was UB40 with Red Red Wine. Number 2 we had Billy Joel with Uptown Girl. And everybody's favourite crossdresser was Culture Club with Karma Chameleon. Yeah, so some decent enough tracks in there. Flying Pickets, they brought out Only You, and they were number 21. Anyway, let's have a look. News-wise, what happened in 1983? Well, I was in third year at school. Let's see, what have we got here? In the UK, seatbelts became mandatory in the United Kingdom. The IRA bomb exploded outside Harrods. That was on the 17th of December. The world's population was estimated at 4.7 billion. Let's see. China's population reached 1 billion. Dear me. The first mobile phone is introduced by the Motorola company. Breakfast TV started. Oh dear. Ronald Reagan proposed the Strategic Defence Initiative, better known as SDI. And Margaret Thatcher wins a landslide victory in the general election. What else interesting happened? Final episode of MASH aired, reaching 125 million people. Cabbage Patch Dolls were released. Star Wars films, Star Wars Episode 6, Return of the Jedi came out. Tootsie, Trading Places, War Games, Superman 3, Flashdance, Staying Alive, Octopussy, National Lampoon's Vacation, Never Say Never Again, Terms of Endearment, Yentl, and Educating Rita. And yeah, that is about all interesting stuff. So anyway guys, on to the more important things. What video games did we play back in 1983? Now, I was going to try and cut them down, but you know what? There's just so many games that I want to include, so I'm going to stick strictly to one game per game. So kicking off, we've got 10 Yard Fight by Irem. Now, I can always remember seeing computer and video games used to have an arcade section. And I always remember seeing this game getting reviewed. I always thought it looked pretty good. It's a game I've actually got to like. Playing it in the main once I actually figured out what I actually had to do. Obviously it's based on American football. Now what's the buttons? There we go. Yep, my idea is to try and score a touchdown. Now you can also do that with passing or running moves. Hey, there we go. I made 10 yards. The wee grid on the right hand side. Yeah, the wee grid on the right hand side shows you where the red line shows you the 10 yard mark, which you have to try and obviously get to. Now you can see there at the top you've got a timer which ticks down, so you can't afford to just keep doing running moves, you've really got to go for a pass. So let's see if I can put a pass together. Ah bollocks, can't remember the button to press. But it's actually quite an addictive wee game. Yeah, your enemy isn't so much the opposing players, it's the actual really silly time limit that you've got. But It's a great wee game, it really is. Obviously, Iron went on to do R-Type. Ah, bollocks, intercepted. So I'll have to retreat 20 yards. But if you like sport games, then... Nah, damn it. If you like sports games, then obviously, guys, look up this game. It's actually really good fun. Got 10 seconds to do something here, which I'm not going to do, I don't think. Hey! I'm certainly not going to get up there. No, I've got 2 seconds to get up. That's not going to happen. Oh, right, I've gained 10 seconds because I obviously made the... Ah, bollocks. I'm going to run out of time now. This game was ported to quite a few systems. Well, I'm saying it was, it wasn't really. I'm talking shit, actually. It was ported to, obviously, the NES. Possibly, that's it, actually. Yeah, it was never ported, that I'm aware, to any of the sort of 8-bit consoles at all, or 8-bit home computers. Anyway, guys, that is 10-yard fight. Let's crack on. Okay, this game is Blaster by Williams. Now, I must admit, it's not a game, dearie me. See, when I see things like that, it's the year 2085. You think to yourself, when that game was written, that was miles in the future. 2085 is not that long away, really. Yeah, this is a game, I must admit, I've never really... I couldn't even tell you what it looks like. I've no idea how this game's going to play. So it uses a trackball, oddly, right? No idea what's going to happen here. Don't even know how the game's going to play or anything. Fly through magic arches. Ah, right, okay, so I need to... Yeah, interesting. Bollocks. It's like an expanded sprite fest. Yeah, now, I noticed a couple of sound effects have been taken from Robotron. Ah, bollocks. It's actually quite funky. Woof. Yeah, like I said, I've heard of the game, but I've never played it. But it's quite a nice looking game. Planetoid Rescue Spacemen. They're definitely stealing a few sound effects from Robotron. Game over. Anyway, that's excellent. That is a Blaster by Williams. This game is called Bristles by First... What are they called? First Star Exidy. So it's always a joint operation. Now, I can't say I've ever seen this arcade game. I've seen it on the... on the Atari 8-bit, so yeah, it was obviously ported. I have no idea what I'm supposed to be doing here. It certainly looks more like... Hey, come on, what am I doing here? Are these lifts? Ah, I'm guessing these are lifts. Right, okay. Oops, what happened there? It's actually, graphically, it's quite poor for an arcade game. What the hell's going on here? I have no idea what's happening. Right, so the idea being I've got to try and paint. Whoops. Ah! bollocks. It's going to be game over, isn't it? Yeah, it's very basic looking for an arcade game for 1983. Now, I'm wondering, did the home version come out first and then they decided to port it to the arcade? Possibly, I'm not too sure. So, I'm going to go along there. Whoops. Ah, bollocks. Yeah, it's like a... It's going more in common with an early Commodore 64 game. That's your idea. I don't appear to be losing any life. So anyway, listen, that's enough of that. What is that called? That's called the bristles. Let's crack on. Okay, this is Congo Bongo. Now, this game was ported to quite a few different machines. It's by Sega. It's kind of a sort of a take on Donkey Kong, which will become clear in a second. The idea is you control this intrepid little guy at the bottom, and you've got to try and get to the top where the big monkey is. But this one's in kind of pseudo 3D. I can remember playing this in the Commodore 64, and it wasn't actually a bad conversion. It's quite tough though, because it's sort of pseudo 3D. It's and you can see there's these little monkeys. Ah, damn it. Yeah, you get these little monkeys. I'm going to go for one more game of this since it was over fairly quickly. But it looks really, really nice. Get to the next level. Okay, now what? No shite. You need to avoid the... Ah, damn it. Yeah, it's a nice looking wee game, this. Arse. Avoid the lobsters. Right, anyway guys, that is Congo Bongo. And that is by Sega. Okay, this one is called Cosmic Chasm by Cinematronics. Now, you can probably tell, hopefully, that it's actually a vector graphics game. Now, I've never ever played this in my life. Well, I'll tell a lie, I played it for about 30 seconds before recording this video because it turns out it actually uses the trackball to move. Now, I'm sure this game has been converted to various systems. Now, I must admit, I quite like the... Haven't a clue, what have I got to do here? Have I got to try and not die, obviously? Can I destroy that? Ah, right. Right, so I've killed the baddies. Damn it, so hitting the walls isn't good. Now can I fly through there? Yes, I can. Now I'm sure this game was ported to the Vectrex. That's possibly where I've heard of it from. I've just noticed I've actually, I don't have the screen shot there, apologies about that. Right, go through here. It's actually got a really nice movement, that's the trackball that I'm using. Anyway guys, listen, that's Cosmic Chasm, and that's by Cinematronics. Okay, this is Crystal Castles. Now, oddly enough, I couldn't get this one working in the MAME cab. I did change the version of MAME that was running in the MAME cab. It used to work fine, but oddly enough, it doesn't anymore, so I'll need to tinker with it. So I'm actually recording this one using the screen capture software. You can probably tell the fact that you can see my ugly face, and most of them that every other game I've featured today, or that has been featured and will, you'll see in the rest of this feature, have all been actually filmed me playing the MAME cab sort of thing. I always think that gives a better perspective of the game sort of thing. So anyway, enough prattling with me. Let's I thought I couldn't leave this game out. This is an absolute classic. The unfortunate thing about it, how do we start? Yeah, unfortunate thing with this game, needs a trackball. It's a trackball game. And it really needs that to play properly for the proper intricate controls that you need. I used to play this quite a lot on the C64, there was a pretty good version. The thing about these games, this early 80s, they weren't entirely processor hungry, so you know, it was all in the programming, you could always get good versions, but it was later on when stuff became more processor hungry that that the 8-bit machines just couldn't keep up, but stuff like this converted pretty well if it was programmed correctly anyway. Yeah, I don't know what it is, the sound in this thing is glitching all over the place. The thing is, if I'm not using the screen capture software, MAME plays beautifully. But things seem to go pear-shaped when I try and use this software. I see, it's obviously just the fact that my PC really isn't up to the job of, come on! Ah, bollocks. Yeah, my PC's not up to the job of actually running MAME and recording it at the same time. But I'll get a new PC eventually. Now this is tricky to say the least, trying to use a joystick with this. Right, anyway guys, listen, that's enough of that. That is Crystal Castles, and that was released by Atari.
Right then, this is Donkey Kong 3. This was obviously released by Nintendo. Hang on, I'm going to just try and get this. No, it doesn't matter. That looks alright. Slightly squint, but who cares? Is that better? Hang on a second. Let's move. Move that up a touch. That's better. Right, yep, this is obviously released by Nintendo. Now again, this is a game I have never ever played in my life. Now, I don't even know, is that even Mario at the bottom? It doesn't look like it. Well, you can certainly see, looking at the sort of side art, it doesn't appear that that's Mario. I don't even know what the idea of the game is. I'm guessing that for starters you need to shoot these bees, I'm guessing. Must admit, the graphics look absolutely gorgeous. Now, I'm guessing you're trying to protect the sort of vegetables or something at the bottom. You know what, it actually reminds me more of, graphically wise, it looks more like Rainbow Islands. The wee character you control and even the wee bees. Let's go for one more game because I haven't a clue what I'm doing here. Yeah, so it's obviously trying to pinch my my beetroots. Yeah, that looks like something out of Rainbow Islands, the wee caterpillar thing. So at what point does this level finish? It actually feels more like a shoot-em-up. It feels more like Galaxian than Donkey Kong. I've done slightly better that time. Well, I didn't exactly achieve anything. Ah, bollocks. Now, I notice when you shoot Donkey Kong up the bum, he seems to make him move further up. Yeah, it's a really nice looking game. You can tell it's more advanced graphically and sound wise from Donkey Kong. Although in my opinion, it doesn't hold a candle to Donkey Kong. Donkey Kong's always going to be a classic game. Can I destroy the bees? No, it doesn't appear I can. Damn it, attacked by a caterpillar. Yeah, it's interesting that they dropped Mario out this version. Wonder what the reason for that is. Anyway guys, that is Donkey Kong 3, and that's by Nintendo. Okay, this game is Elevator Action. Now this was a game that spawned quite a lot of different versions on the home computer. It wasn't really a game I was particularly fond of, I must admit, though. I can't say I've ever played the arcade one. I'm not quite sure of the aim of the game is, other than you get these little baddies that come out of doorways and you've got to sort of shoot them. And obviously try not to get shot yourself. I'm really not too sure. Okay. Unfortunately, there's a bezel thing around this, but it's not of a sufficient quality that you can actually... And the lights appear to have gone out. Yeah, it's not of a quality you can actually read the writing, unfortunately. Damn it. It kind of does tell you the object of the game is, but it doesn't really... I can't read any more than that, unfortunately. Alright, so I can control whether a lift moves up or down. Right, okay, listen, that is Elevator Action. I'm sure it is quite a good game. It's certainly one that's says it was ported to a hell of a lot of systems. In fact, you know what, let's go for one more game. I didn't really give that much in the way of time play, so let's go for it once more. Ah, so you can walk on the top as well, I see. Can you go through doors? Now you can jump. Damn it. Oh, I'm not quite sure what makes the lights go off. That was silly. Oh, close. So what is the idea of the game? Is it to get to the bottom or something? I can see that I'm on floor 22. Ah, there's a red door. That looks interesting. Right, anyway, I know that's enough of that one. That is elevator action, and that is by Tito. Okay, guys, this game is an absolute classic. It's a favourite of mine. It is Gyrus, and that is by Konami. This game was ported to... Well, it was certainly ported to the Commodore 64. But it's got a cracking version in that. It's actually very arcade-like. The music for this really helped make the game. Absolute brilliant shooter. So, excuse me while I indulge myself. That's a... Well, I'll crack a joke when it comes to it. But this is a great game. Like I said, it was ported to the C64. I think it was out in Atari 8-bit as well. It was probably just a bit too early for... Did it come out in the Spectrum? It certainly didn't come out in Amstrad. Certainly not official versions, anyway. But I absolutely love this game of bits. It's got some great sound effects as well. Now, I'm not sure if this game utilised a spinner, because basically all you can see, you're just moving there. To get the joystick working, what you need to do is pressing left and right makes you move to a point, but you need to kind of spin the joystick 360 degrees, if that makes any sense, to kind of position. This is just a bonus stage. There you go, three warps to Uranus. That provided a barrel of laughs as a 16-year-old. I wish I was probably older than 16. And again, being an arcade game, it's a game that gets hard very quickly. The first couple of levels seem fairly sedate. Ah, damn it. But yeah, this is one of my favourite shooters of all time. You've got to be on your toes the whole time. What you want to try and do is shoot that orange thing, because that gives you double firepower, which you need. It's a bit like Galactica, as far as the further in you get, they start kind of attacking you. As they come in at the start, they sort of peel off like so. And kill you. Woo! Great game. Anyway, guys, that is Gyrus, and that is by Konami. Okay, this is Hunchback, and this is by Century Electronics. Now, this was one of the very first games I ever played on my C64. didn't even know it was released as an arcade game. But yeah, this was converted by Ocean Software to the Spectrum C64. I must admit, the C64 one was actually a pretty good conversion, but then looking at this, there's not a great deal to actually be done. The idea being you've got to try and navigate along the castle ramparts to rescue Esmeralda, and you can see that at the bottom right there's a little a little sort of map of where you are, this little thing down the bottom which you may or may not be able to see. There we go, that's better. But looking at this, I could actually see that the C64 was probably one of the finest conversions of any arcade game, but it's really less to do with the conversion and more to do with how poor the original was. Ouch! That would be painful. Yeah, it's all about timing, and you may or may not see there's a little guard at the bottom who's gonna come towards you with his chopper. So you've got to... This is one of these games, you really have to play it to get to know, because playing it for the first time like myself, you would never have any idea what was going to happen, so it's very much a memory test game. I'm not quite sure what's going to happen here. Thought. Yeah, anyway guys, that is Hunchback, and that is by Century Electronics. Go and check out the Spectrum or Commodore 64, which had really good versions of that. Okay guys, this is iRobot. Now this is a game that is regarded as a bit of a classic. Never ever played it in my life. I've only ever seen pictures of it. It was made by Atari. Now interestingly, before I started recording it, you'll see here, you've got two options. You've got Doodle City, which is basically a drawing game. You can actually just draw, which is most odd. Now, you know, I've got absolutely no idea what I'm doing here. It appears I'm using the trackball. Haven't a clue what I'm supposed to be doing here. I open. What does that say? I've got no idea what the idea is. Get reds. Ah, so do I need to go over that thing? Oops. Shoot birds, right? It's telling me to shoot the birds, okay. Yeah, I appear to get some. Get four reds, so I'm guessing it's talking about this. Do not jump if I is red. Like, this has completely got me bamboozled. No idea. It says get reds, and I'm trying to move over the little red squares at the bottom, but it doesn't seem to do very much. Anyway, listen, that's enough of that one. That is iRobot, and that was released by Atari. Okay, this is Juno First, and this is by Konami. This is an absolute cracking game. Crack it if you like, shoot 'em ups. This is absolute dog's bollocks. Now, if you want to get big scores, what you do here is don't shoot anything. It's kind of similar to... It's kind of similar to Beam Rider on the Atari and C64. Yeah, what I'm trying to do here is you can move forwards or backwards. I'm trying to maximise points. You've got a little spaceman up here in a second. And if you shoot the spaceman, it then gives you... It gives you the opportunity to score some big points. Pick up this guy, and then you start blasting all these guys, and you'll see there you're getting huge big points for everything. But it's an absolute cracking game. It is arcade shoot 'em ups at their very, very best. Right, I'm gonna no bother with the points, I'm just gonna try and play it. Again, it's one of these games, it looks quite sedate to begin with. But it soon picks up. And you'll soon see you get these little home and missile things, which are absolute pigs to try and kill. But this is a great game. Ah, damn it. I did play a port of this on the C64, and it's excellent. This was a game that was never really, I'd never really heard of it. I didn't even know it was an arcade game until, I would say, I don't know, maybe in the last 10 years. It was never regarded as one of the classic games, but in my opinion it is. It's an absolute cracker. And I've even got a high score as well. So anyway guys, that is Juno First, and that is by Konami. Okay, this game is called Mad Planets, and it's by Gottlieb. Press fire for start of new day, clear ultra scores. Okay, right. Now, I'm sure this uses some bizarre controls, so I've never played it. Right, okay, right, this is going to be a bit... It uses here... Oof, it uses the trackball to rotate, the joystick to move, and the fire button to fire, so this is going to be interesting. It's not the... I reckon it's going to need some configuring. Now, I remember playing a version of this on the C64 called Crazy Comets, I think it was. I'm actually using my pinky to spin the trackball. It's actually working fairly well until I open my big fat mouth. Well, let's go for one more game of that. I think the smaller they are, they blow up quicker. And basically, the more you shoot them, the angrier they become, and the more sort of random they start to move. Never played this though. I remember I even found the Commodore 64 one just a bit too tough. It's an interesting control system. Never used my pinky like that before to control something. Woof! Do I pick them up? I certainly do. If I can. Without hitting an asteroid, I'm guessing. Come on. Come on. Right, that's a bonus thing, I'm guessing. Blimey, it's pretty tough. And I'm doing a lot better than I thought I was going to do. There's some good sound as well. You'll probably not notice it, but the whole arcade cab's actually shaking with the amount of reverb. Anyway, listen, that's Mad Planets, and that is by Gottlieb. Okay, this is Major Havoc, and this is by Atari. Again, it's a game I've never ever played before, but I've heard about it. I'm sure I've even seen pictures of it. I've got no idea how it's going to play. Destroy fish. Right, now, right away I've discovered it actually uses the trackball. I wonder what it was with the vector graphics and trackballs. Seeing that I quite dock in the white platform. Strange thing. Hold button for higher jumps. Hup! A bit like Pac-Man, right. I've no idea what I'm supposed to be doing here. Do I go in here? Get out! Get out! Whoa! Come on. Over. Right, run. Oh, I need to run over here, and then let me out. Strange game. Destroy enemy ships. Yeah, it's a bizarre game. It's shoot 'em up with a bit of platform maze type stuff as well. I don't like this bit at all. It's an interesting use of vector graphics, I must admit. I guess I need to follow the arrows. Is that oxygen? No, too, it must be. Come on! Damn it. Whoa! It's not the easiest game in the world. Right, come on, run. Do I need to avoid these little things, whatever they are? Yes! It turns into a skeleton. It's quite clever. Right, anyway, listen, that's enough of that one, guys. That is Major Havoc, and that is my Atari. Okay, this is Mappy. Now, this is a game I've never actually seen in an arcade, getting played in arcades, but I did. Hang on, I'm going to put something else underneath this. I did. It's one of these games that's been released on a lot of different systems. It's been released in sort of various compilations. Namco are quite prolific. Move Mappy throughout house collecting treasures. TV sets, radios, avoiding the cats. It's So what exactly are you? Are you a cop or something? And Mona Lisa. So basically the idea is you jump, and then when you get to the bit you want to go into, you you basically press the joystick to the side. Right, where am I going now? Have I not got everything? Is that the first level completed? Hey! That's interesting. Now I'm guessing I can't go up there because I'll just bounce back down again. Ah, oh, damn it. Oh. Right, the cat's got me. Okay. Right, so how am I going to get up there? So I need to go down here, and then go up here, open that door, get the ghetto blast up. You don't appear to be able to jump. So where now? Ah, bugger. Nah, you can't jump over these things. Anyway, that's enough of that one. That is Mappy. And that is by Namco. Okay, this is Mario Brothers. And this is by Nintendo. Now I remember playing a particularly good version of this on the Commodore 64. The idea of this game is to basically flip over the baddies and then kill them. It's actually a really good game. Now to flip them over, you wait for them to pass above and then you jump. It's got some lovely little graphics, so the animation is just fantastic. Like so. And that pow thing at the bottom is basically, you've only got a limited number of uses, but if you use that, you will basically flip over everything on the screen, like so. But you've only got a short space of time to go and get the guys, and you'll see there the wee guy at the bottom has now he's now timed himself up the right way, and he's a different colour, which means he's now going even faster. Quick! Oof. You know, I think that fireball is, you just basically have to avoid it. Ah, bollocks. So I need to be quick here. I don't want him writing himself again. That's it. But the great thing with this game is you can actually play with... you can play with two players. I'm making a total arse of this. Total pig's ear of this. But yeah, that animation of the little sprites is just brilliant. Now these guys, the wee crabs, you've got to hit them twice. Let's use this. Thank you. Ah, damn it, I just write them again, which you don't want to do. Now, the first time you flip them over or hit them, he gets even quicker. Be quick. Whoa, 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 whoa. Ah, damn it. This is a great game. Really worth checking out. He's one angry crab. Wow, bollocks. Game over. Anyway guys, that is Nintendo Brothers. Sorry, Mario Brothers I should say, and that's by Nintendo. Okay, this is Mr. Doo's Castle by Universal. Now this is a follow-up to Mr. Doo. Now the idea of this game is to, I believe, kill all the baddies. And I'm not doing a very good job at here. Yeah, now you can kill them in a number of ways. I think you can, or they can kill you. You can knock them in a hole, and then knock a block down on top of them. Now I've never, bloody hell! I am awful at these games. I really am. It's got the same little character, Mr. Doo. Ah, bollocks. Ah, so if they're walking on a yellow platform, you can Right, so that just gives you a certain bonus thing then. Ah, now can I kill these guys then? Right, now they seem to restore the blocks. Yeah, I never played the arcade version of this, although I did play the, there was a Kraken conversion on the Commodore 64. Oops, they have just multiplied. That's probably not a good idea. Haha, you can see there, once they turn colour they go a bit quicker as well. Yeah, anyway guys, that is Mr. Doo's Castle, and that is by Universal. Okay, this is a game that needs a little introduction. This is a follow-up to the Mighty Pole Position by Atari. Who do we actually start? Come on, where do we start? Now you can tell this is a... Right, now think I've got this right. Yeah, now this this game, obviously a follow-up to the first Pole Position, it had, the first one only had one track, whereas the follow-up had four, I think it was, and I'm doing the easiest one here. You know, even though I'm in high gear, it still feels like I'm going off a slow. Ah, oh, come on, you twat. Well, that was rubbish, I didn't even qualify, let's go again. Yeah, I don't think Pole Position 2 was ever ported to any home machines. I might be wrong with that. Come on, how do we start? It's a fiendishly tough game this, so I'm using the trackball, which gives you better control. Trying to play this using a digital joystick is nigh on impossible. You need the analog control. Because trying to get past some of these cars, get through these spaces, is nigh on impossible. Oh, it's better. I've missed it. In the wrong gear there, but not much point in changing now. Oh, yeah, it's very, very twitchy this game. Oof. I've made an arse of that. Should have stayed in the lower gear there. I'm going to run out of time. Great game though. That's Pole Position 2. And that is by the mighty Atari. This little game here, guys, is Rock and Rope by Konami. Now, I've never played the arcade version. I'd never even heard of the game until it was one of these games that was featured on one of the sort of compilations. So let's give it a wee blast. It's certainly a game I've heard of, but never played it. Now it looks, well, it doesn't look anything similar, but it's got the similar. Whoa! It's got similar controls to Bionic Commando, insofar as you fire this little rope thing. Ah, dearie me, you got to press up possibly? I'm not too sure, but looking at it, you play the part of an intrepid explorer. Right, so you press up. Ah, no. He's gonna kill me. Ah, bollocks, so you die when you fall off a platform as well. Okay, let's go again for this one. I don't know whether you can actually go in these little Ah, bollocks, right, okay, so when the other wee cave guy gets hold of the rope, he can basically shake you off it. It's actually quite nice little game mechanics, this, so I've never ever played it. Don't kill me now, please, no. I get the feeling I was about to complete the level there. It's actually quite a nice wee game though. Really nice wee graphics. Ah, balls. Anyway guys, that's quite a good wee game. That's Rock and Rope. And that is by Konami. Right then, this is Spy Hunter. And that is by Bally Midway. Now any 8-bit owner would remember this game pretty well. It was ported by, I think it was US Gold. And it was an excellent game. Now, I don't know whether this is joystick. Alright, okay, so it's a trackball. Alright, okay, so I've got... bugger off. Yeah, I play this a lot. Oh, damn it. My timing's perfect at times, it really is. Yeah, I play this a lot in the C64. Oops, I think that was a... that was a goodie I just destroyed. It was quite chunky graphics in the C64, but it was excellent. This is quite twitchy, using the trackball. This game is the one where it famously splits into... oh, did I just miss a... I'll pick up the... I think I did. Bugger off. Get! Ah, oh, away you go. Yeah, this is a game where you famously change into a speedboat. I don't even know if I'm going to last long enough to actually... right, there's another. You can bugger off. Yeah, these other lorries, they drop extra weapons. This would probably be easier. Ah, oh, damn it. You got that car there that's got the big spikes. Straight off, onto water, into a tree. I certainly found the C64 one a bit easier. Right, you can pass off. Ah, dearie me. That is really difficult. I'm going to have that one more go. I'm guessing it may be easier with a steering wheel. One thing I think is a shame about this game is The music there is excellent. It really adds to the atmosphere. And unfortunately, it doesn't last very long. Now, I didn't remember having that accelerate button on the 64 version. Right, I've just noticed with this control, if you push it to the side, it keeps moving in that direction. It doesn't sort of self-centre. So is that some sort of turbo boost thing? Oh, you can... That was silly. Whoa! Ah, no way. Once he hits you, it's curtains. There's just no way of actually recovering. Come on. I'm determined to get to the speedboat thing. Come on. Right, listen, one more life. And I think we'll move on to something else. Right, come on you. Hurry up. One weapons van. Right, enough of that. That guys is Spy Hunter. And that is by Bally Midway. Okay, I've turned the sound up for this one guys. This is Star Wars. Now this is regarded by many as probably one of the finest video games ever released. It's certainly, if you ever sort of look at like a what arcade game is your favourite, what arcade game would you most like to own, this one is one that crops up a lot. This one obviously came, the game itself came in a big sit down cab and it had the proper yoke sort of controls. Absolute classic. Now the only chance I actually got to play this game was they had one of these in Bathgate Arcade, but I didn't get a chance to play it very often. Now as you can probably tell, I'm not the greatest at this game. It's the controls are uses the trackball.
Use the force, Luke.
Right, stuff that, let's just shoot everything. Yeah, and it uses the forwards, goes down, and vice versa. Pushing forwards. It's basically flight controls, which I'm not really too used to.
Luke, trust me.
Never noticed that. May the force be with you was written on the side of the Death Star there. Is that what normally happens? Just noticed them actually. Wait, I'll move in a wee bit. That's better. Now one thing I've noticed in MAME, the version of this, you seem to skip to the Death Star very, very quickly after shooting just a handful of ships. And I don't believe that would have been the case.
I'm here to drop that R2, do you want to do with it? Red 5, I'm
going in. It's a great game, that's it really is. Some great conversions. The 16-bit computers, the Atari ST and Commodore Amiga, they had a great conversions, and it was great using the mouse as well.
Strong.
That had writing on it again, I never ever noticed that before. Now I've got to say, I'm actually doing much better than I thought I was going to do.
Day in a back point.
And as he speaks, it's game over. Brilliant. That is the mighty Star Wars by Atari Games. Okay, this is Tapper, and this that's by Bally Midway. Now, this game actually came out in two, pun intended, flavours. It's called Tapper, and this is Budweiser edition. But because it featured beer, they figured they'd bring out a kid-friendly one, so they brought out another Tapper called the root beer version. Now the idea of this game is to basically serve pints to your thirsty customers by pressing the fire button. Now what you have to make sure doesn't happen is you serve a pint to somebody when there's nobody there, because then the glass will smash. And you lose a life. But if any of the customers get to the end of the bar, they'll grab you and pull you across the bar. And what you can do is you can move from the top. Now when the dancers start, you'll see some of them stop to watch. So you need to be careful you don't throw a glass when there's nobody ready to catch it. Ah, damn it. It's actually, although it's a very, very simple game, it's quite a tricky game as well. Now this game, I believe, actually had a proper pint serving control system, which would have been pretty cool. This game was converted by US Gold. Now this is what you need to do, is watch for the one that he doesn't shake, and it's never easy. Now I've lost already, you know what, you've got to look for the one that he didn't shake. Now I used to be able to do this when I was younger, but now... Okay. Ah, bollocks. But it's a great wee game, but it's tougher than it looks. Because you've really got to make sure you don't throw down a pint when there's nobody there to collect it. Thank you. Sometimes you never think you're going to get to the end of a level. Oh, no. Damn it. Anyway, guys, that is a tapper. And that is by Bally Midway. Okay, right then, guys, this game, to anybody that watches my channel on a regular basis, probably knows that this is one of my favourite arcade games of all time. That's an absolute cracker. I'm not too bad at this game. I can usually get through the first 2-3 rounds if I'm lucky. I don't get the hammer enough, but absolutely cracking game this. Now this game, I believe, was imported to the NES, and there was also an official version came out in the C64, although it was only released in the UK, in America. You know what, I'm going to have to stand up for this. I'm trying to do that whilst hunched over is no good. Yeah, this was it was never released officially for the Spectrum or any other sort of 8-bit machines that I'm aware of. That was rubbish. It doesn't help the fact that I'm kinda trying to squat over a camera. I used to think I wasn't bad at this game until I see other people playing it. Absolutely staggering how good some people are at this game. Now what I'll probably do, guys, is just play one round of it, because I can usually play it for quite a while, which I don't want to do today. This genre was obviously made famous by Daley Thomson's Decathlon, which was released by Ocean Software. That was crap. And it was responsible for the death of 1,000 quickshot joysticks. Absolutely love the competitive bollocks aspect of this game. You know, you can see your name up in lights and you can try and beat your high score. It's just a brilliant game. Wow. Yeah, if you watch any YouTube videos of people who are actually good at this game, you'll see they use they kind of drum their fingers across the buttons. And what can only be described as astonishing. There were other versions of sort of exactly the same thing that came out. I'll need to concentrate on this. Should be enough to qualify. That'll be enough. Yeah, that'll do. Yeah, there was obviously various decathlon type games that came out on the sort of 8-bit, the home computers. There was a cracking version called Decathlon by... Oh, that's not bad. By who brought it out? Activision, yeah. This event that I'm doing just now is the one that I find the most difficult. To me, it comes down to luck. Oh, that's going to be a cracker as well. There you go, got three throws. This particular event can go on and on and on and on and on. Because the annoying thing is, every round you start at 215. And obviously the qualification height goes up. So it can take a wee while. You can see there, this particular event can drag on a bit. Now for many, many years, I never knew you could actually waggle the joystick or press the button to gain height. I just thought you could only tap it once and then try and control yourself to go over it. But you'll see here, hopefully if I can go over this one. Ah, bollocks. The more you press it, the higher you go. So that's the secret to that particular event. Right, that is the end of that one. Okay guys, that is Track and Field, and that is by Konami. Okay, this is Up and Down. This is by Sega. Now this again was one of the games that was converted by US Gold. Well, I don't know if it was converted by US Gold, but it was certainly released by US Gold. Actually, now I think about it, this may... I'll zoom in a wee bit. This may actually be... This game, Spy Hunter, not Spy Hunter, that was made by Bally Midway. You know, I was going to say it may have actually been converted by Sega itself. Not too sure. The idea of this game is to try and collect flags without dying. Now, I think you can, you can sort of jump up and land on top of other cars. Bet you don't want to do that. Dearie me, that was a quick game. Let's go again. What's interesting from all these games I've been looking at over the last couple of years, the whole sort of timed element of it that was prevalent in the sort of the early 80s. Or late 70s, early 80s, has disappeared. Back then, all these games were... How did that get up there? Yeah, back in sort of 1980, you got like 2 minutes worth of gameplay, regardless of how you did. Whereas all the games sort of thereafter, it's based on lives and how good you were. Right, now, why can't I get up there? I think it shows you, it does. Now, what's the point of that wee one there with the... Come on! Ah, bollocks! Anyway guys, listen, that is Up and Down. And that is the very last version, last game I should say, we're going to look at for 1983. As you can see, there's a lot of cracking games. I mean, there was, I don't know how many, there's probably literally a couple of hundred games released this year. I've just really picked the ones that I can sort of remember that, you know, the name is familiar to me, but there's loads more. But yeah, anyway guys, listen, I hope you've enjoyed watching this video. Please feel free to subscribe, leave comments, like, that would be brilliant. And as usual guys, thank you very much for watching.